Thank you. Thank you. So this song has a very special story because it concerns you totally. In 2001, I made a record called Trouble in Shangri-La, and about 3 months after that happened, 9/11 happened. We stayed out on the road for a month or 6 weeks maybe, and then we went home. And I was upset about a lot of things at that point. And one of the things I was upset about, besides 9/11, was the fact that the internet, to me, was just taking away the reason that we did this, which was to be able to afford to support yourself when you wrote music. And I wasn't looking at it as, I'm already rich. Okay, great, that's not the point. The fact is that I write music, it's like you make a painting and you're gonna sell it. And if you can't sell it, then you're just gonna keep it. And so that's what happens when you're an artist. You get very possessive about things that you make or that you write for people. You write a book, you want them to pay $8 for it. It's like, it's not a big deal. I mean, maybe it's a big deal, but it's not a big deal to the artist, because that's how we take care of ourselves. That's how we buy food. And I know that sounds completely ridiculous. Of course I can buy food in 2001, but still. So I said, I'm not making any more records. And I walked away and I didn't make another record until I came to Australia with Fleetwood Mac in 2009. I did the Fleetwood Mac tour, and we were in Melbourne, and they have this great like theater in this hotel that had like the chaise lounges, the barca lounges, whatever you want to call them. And we didn't have those in the United States. It was like, oh my God. So great. And so I rented a theater for all my crew and the band, everybody, and we went and I made them all go. I did. I said, okay, we're going to go and see the second Twilight movie. You can just only imagine how excited that most of my crew was about that. All right. So anyway, we go down to see this movie. And I'm like, you know, I love movies about vampires and witches, so it's like, it's going to be great for me. So that's really all I actually care about. And I wanted them to come too. So I'm sitting there, I watch it, and all of a sudden I'm like embroiled in this story. And some people were and some people weren't, but I was. And I just fell in love with the love story of Bella and Edward. I wanted to be Bella. I wanted to know Edward. And I wanted to write about them. So when the movie was over, everybody left, and we just love that movie, Stevie. Everybody left. And I'm sitting there, me and my assistant Karen and a friend of ours who was working for us, who's actually here tonight also. And so we get in this really serious conversation about love and why you love somebody and what you're willing to take to stay with that person and what you're willing to give to be in a relationship and what love actually does to you and how it can change you for the better or not. And my friend, our friend, he was just like, I just don't understand this at all. This is just insane. And I'm like, and then I'm mad. I'm mad at him because he's not getting it. So I am harping on this all the way from the theater into the elevator, all the way upstairs into the hotel room. And finally, I just think, okay, you just don't get it. And so I go into this really lovely little room that has a desk in it and a view. And like I said, it's the place. And I sat down and I wrote the poem to that song. And I came out of it going like, okay, I love this. I love this poem. It's not a song yet, but I love it. Then we went on to Brisbane the next day, and there was a piano in the entryway of this suite. And I went, okay, it's a sign. So I sat down, I had a camera. I didn't have a recording equipment. I put the camera on the piano. I pushed, you know, video, turning it to the other side. Pushed video, and I sat down, and I played it all the way through, exactly as you just heard it. And I stood up, and I knew my assistant was hovering somewhere after waiting 8 years for me to do this. And I said, okay, I'm ready to make a record now. So, I want you to go home. I want you to call Dave Stewart, and I want you to call Waddy, and I want you to tell him that I want to make a record. And that was all because of Australia. Had it not been for me being here and seeing that movie, I don't know that I would have ever made another record. I wouldn't have made In Your Dreams, which was like the second time I made it. I wouldn't have made 24 Karat Gold, which is why I'm here this time. And I would have been just out of the game. So I thank you for that, because it's more important than you can ever imagine. I thank you from the bottom of my heart for that. So, and love is good. Passion is good. It's all good.